Flight boss, bitch, you know, for sure. You're now listening to the Mind of an Aterius Moon. I'm the Archangel Uriel, and I'm here to carry out God duties and motherfucking responsibilities. And don't be caught being guilty by affiliation. Because being guilty by affiliation can put you in a spiritual jail. Being guilty by affiliation can fuck up your frequency vibration. Being guilty by affiliation can fuck up your timelines. You see what I'm saying? So it's best to separate yourself. Separate yourself from all things. And when you go within, you're actually connecting yourself to all things. So you're separating yourself and connecting yourself at the same time, which create a centerpiece, which create an orb between the positive and negative charges, which creates creativity in a five nature, a five-pointed star, or five senses, or five verses, whatever. The fifth dimension, you know what I'm saying? And everything, because it's a balance. Now, when we want to talk about not being guilty by affiliation, now you have a lot of 3D beings that you're gonna be around that so 3D and don't even understand what they're doing in their own life, to the point that they create timelines for you to experience. And if you're not spiritually inclined enough, you won't understand. You know what I'm saying? You won't understand why you're experiencing certain experiences that you're experiencing. You know what I'm saying? So it goes deep. It goes even as far as deep as you see people who got brought to America, people who got brought on land and shit like that. That's the same way how your spirit got enticed to be here. Like you go into the vessel that you frequency vibrate with, but the locations and the areas you go is what entice your what? Your desire, your passion. So in this solar system, we got heavy ass lights. We got Venus light that you could get blinded by. By pleasures and overindulging and shit. It was a gang of shit in the solar system that enticed your spirit. And the oversouls stay on planets that can't inhabit physical bodies. So they going around here preaching these lights, showing these lights from planets and giving them to people as an oversoul. So as when a person get it from an oversoul, numerous of people was getting it and carrying out those duties and obligations. So you basically was in the middle of a slave trade as a spirit and shit like that. So when you come here, you have to understand the same way you living on a land that's not yours. So you have to do certain situations and have certain ideas to go amongst the land, the same way how you came to a location in the spiritual realm. And so your thoughts ain't yours. You know what I'm saying? A lot of your feelings and emotions ain't yours. You know what I'm saying? So when you get to a spiritually inclined position in your life, you're able to understand what's yours and what ain't yours. What you brought and what you put out and what's brought on to you and what you're receiving. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of times you have a lot of humans who may be around you, a lot of niggas and bitches that may be around you who don't really understand this. And once you get, see, look, people need to understand when they talking to me, they not just talking to anybody. And if you part of my soul group, you need to be just like that. You need to be just like that. Because some shit is so less dense, so not dense, that it'd be petty to try to bring it into, explain it into physical reality, or why you may or may not fuck with a chick or a dude, or why you may or may not want to be in a certain circumstance or situation. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of times it'd be petty, because a lot of the world is so on earth that to even bring these thoughts down to present it to a person, you'll leave a person like, damn, what the fuck did I do, or what the fuck is this? But see, a lot of times people don't understand. And then when you get a spiritually discernment, you know, anytime someone is talking heavily about you, having heavy emotions about you, you're going to pick up those realms of realities, and you're going to experience those frequencies, whether you like it or not. The more dense you is, the more it has to be in front of you, the more in reality it has to be in front of you. But it's going to come in some way, shape, or form before it comes in front of you, or before you even being around that person to pick up the frequency vibrations. So me being me, I already know. I be knowing. But a lot of times, it be shit that I know that an average human not supposed to know. So for me to bring it down here into human existence and express that, a lot of times to certain girls or certain dudes, it'd be seen as nonchalant. It'd be seen as like, what the fuck? You know what I'm saying? And a lot of times you have to let humans have that. Let them have that. Let them have when they at home by themselves or talking to somebody and going through their changes and talking about you the way they talk about you. Let them have that. You know what I'm saying? But just know when you're talking to me, you come to me, I know all that shit, and I pick that shit up off everything. So a lot of times you got people around you who are trying to create timelines, create certain realms of realities and certain frequencies and try to make themselves a part of you, and try to make themselves a part of you, then find themselves needing you to do you. No, you have to separate yourself from these people. I don't care how you do it, what kind of way you do it. These people are vampires. They succubus, because their ideas and their thoughts and their feelings ain't theirs. So then when they act on a thought or a feeling that ain't theirs, they need the people where they got that idea and thought from to actually carry out those duties and obligations. And then a lot of times these peoples, they be needing you and needing you as a representation, or needing you as a spectacle in order to help their energy or whatever force field or whatever realm of reality they dealing with. And that's when I say, no, if you're part of my soul group, no, detach yourself, separate yourself from all that kind of shit. You know what I'm saying? Like me, I'm not a part of no clique. I ain't a part of no gang. Everything I got was mine's is mine's, not ours. Mine's. You know what I'm saying? And I'm getting to a point where I'm not helping nobody else. You know what I'm saying? I'm not, everything come with a fee. I'm not finna put myself, I'm already doing me. So you're not finna utilize me to do me. What you need to do is do you. You know what I'm saying? And everybody in the soul group need to understand that. Now, ain't nothing wrong with someone who may come to you for some knowledge, come for you to some wisdom, some information. The moment somebody needs you to do something in the physical realm of reality, in this 3D realm, this is not for my soul group. We're not doing that. You know what I'm saying? You could be guilty by affiliation and start experiencing frequencies and vibrations. And then 9 times out of 10, you be doing that for people who don't even really fuck with you like that. You know what I'm saying? You need to put everything in perspective in your life. You know what I'm saying? Know what lines to cross and know what not to cross. Know where to keep certain people and know where not to keep certain people. Everybody ain't a person you need to be doing everything with. You don't need to be, if you're a girl, you don't need to be doing makeup, hair and makeup with all your friends. All your friends ain't good at doing hair and makeup. A lot of them probably hate the way you do hair and makeup. A lot of them might not ever come around you like that. And the moment they want to decide to wake up and now they want to do hair and makeup, who they calling? They calling you to do hair and makeup. And this person don't even fuck with you like that. You don't even fuck with that. That 9 times out of 10, that person probably, that bitch probably did a whole bunch of fluky shit. She probably fucked your dude, probably called your dude, told your dude you was cheating. You know what I'm saying? Because of who she was talking to. And then she was probably in the realm of reality to whoever she was talking to, was fucking her mind up, making her think all kind of shit about you and the people she was around. And then she ain't even around that dude no more. So now she got all these ideas and thoughts, throwing them on you, need you for shit like that, and you don't even fuck with her like that. But you don't want to just dish her off like that though. But she keep trying to attach herself, make herself a part of you. She with your beauty salon. She always screaming your beauty salon. She always want to work at your beauty salon. You know what I'm saying? She always want to do hair and makeup with all y'all and shit like that. And then you just be looking at this chick like, bitch, you barely know how to do hair and makeup. And then I don't even like you. I forgive, but I don't forget everything you did. So I forgive you enough for you to be around, but I don't forget to for you to think that we finna be all I'm finna be teaching you how to do makeup and you finna be using my makeup stall and all this for free. No! I don't even fuck with you like that. You see what I'm saying? So that's what you have to learn how to separate people. When people do certain things in your life, you keep them there in that box. You know what I'm saying? And for you don't be creating no frequency vibrations that's going on in your life, because this is what's gonna happen. When you're looking at a timeline, first of all, when you start to rise yourself off the ground, right? Here's what happens, right? You're gonna start to see the timeline, period. Then you're gonna start to decipher, like, okay, why is I'm utilizing this time for this time, right? Then once you start getting that rectified, you start understanding your own time and start understanding your own timeline, you get higher. Then you're gonna start seeing what's trying to create timelines for you. Because, look, you are already in life, and if you're naive to the things, your timelines is going crazy, right? Once you get a hold of yourself and start to figure out, why is I wasting time on this and why I don't have to do this, you're elevating, right? So now, soul groups Over Souls and shit out there is now is looking at it like, okay, this person is gaining control of themselves now. So now they'll start attacking you. Okay, if you got a hold of your own time, and when, once you reach in that area, it's gonna be, you're gonna be thinking like this, no, I ain't doing that today, or I'm doing this, or I'm doing this when I do this. Then that's when they create a timeline, then that's when you're gonna see it. Because you're gonna be like, hold on, why I gotta do this? I didn't create this for myself. And a lot of times, they the only way they can come once you get to that level is through things that your name is already on. Through mail, through friends, through family. You know what I'm saying? They got to come in other ways. They can't come through just directly TV and regular shit anymore. They have to come through shit like that, right? Then you may get played around in that realm for a little bit. Then once you decipher that now, once you start detaching yourself from certain shit now, like if you got a certain mail that sent it to you and they keep calling, once you get that rectified, get that out your way, and start doing shit like that to start to get your time back on that level, then that's when these motherfucker oversouls start getting desperate. Then it's just, they just start showing themselves. You start to see them in your time. You know what I'm saying? Because they can't affect you because you probably start cutting your phone off, so they can't affect you through fans and family. They can't affect you from the first place again because you got a hold of your own time. So they just start showing themselves. And you know how they show themselves? If they don't got nobody to come up and knock on your door, even if they've been calling you and you ain't even answering, they'll pop up at your house. If they ain't got no physical snake body to do that in, then they start showing themselves through the mental, through your thoughts and your feelings and emotions. To the point you may be just sitting back, right, and just catch a thought. Catch it like a daydream thought. You'd be like, where the fuck did that come from, right? You better dissect that shit. You'd be catching feelings, catching waves. And then you catch those feelings and emotions from nowhere. You just catch a vibe. You better get discerning about that. Because if you travel, like I said, go in the yin realm and travel and start to see where that shit come from, you know exactly where it come from. You can find the house it came from, the actual person it came from, and everything. Just like me, I know when you bitches, you niggas, is talking shit about me. I know when y'all motherfuckers are somewhere in y'all own facility talking about I'm weird, or talking about I'm this, that, and the third, or I ain't this, I ain't that, I ain't this, and I ain't that. I already know that shit. Then when you motherfuckers come around, you... I smile and laugh all motherfucking day. I will smile and laugh all motherfucking day at your snake sucker by motherfucking ass. And that's real. I even help you. Because that's who I am. I'm Archangel Uriel. But just don't sit up nowhere and think I fucking forgot. Don't think that. I'm cool, but I ain't friendly. That's one thing I ain't, the moment you need me to do something in physical reality, I'm a motherfucking planet, bro. I'm a motherfucking planet. I'm not on this earth to do that. And my soul group not on this earth to do that either. You see what I'm saying? So don't be guilty by motherfucking affiliation. Because you don't want to be experiencing what these motherfucking other niggas is out here and these other bitches out here experiencing. Because it'll create all kind of timelines for you that you don't want to experience. Flight boss, bitch. Goddamn air.